boys and girls. I sure hope you enjoyed our story, Fox in Socks by Dr. Seuss today, that we read in honor of Dr. Seuss's birthday. Yay! Happy birthday, Dr. Seuss. And I sure hope that you had fun reading a good book today, as today is Read Across America Day in honor of Dr. Seuss's birthday. And if you didn't have a chance to read a book yet, well, don't worry. You can always read one tomorrow or the rest of this week, because the library has a lot of great books written by Dr. Seuss and other authors. So feel free to come on down to the Herr Memorial Library and check out a couple books. In the meantime, we're going to do some crafts that have to do with our story, Fox and Socks, today. And another favorite Dr. Seuss classic, Red Fish, Blue Fish. Oh, I'm sorry. It's One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish. See, I get so excited. And he wrote so many fun stories. So we're going to go ahead and do those two crafts. And if you happen to stop in the library, we have these craft kits already prepared for you. Everything, almost everything you need is inside. And then we also have some fun STEM activities, some birthday party games that you can play with your family and friends in honor of Dr. Seuss's birthday. So right now we're going to show you how to do our crafts. The first craft I want to tell you about is our One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue craft. And this is a really easy craft for some of our youngest patrons to do. All you really need to do is have a pair of scissors and a glue stick at home, and we provide the rest. If you're not able to come into the library, you can still do this craft. All you need to do is go onto the internet and print off a picture of a fishbowl on blue paper, and then get yourself some white paper and some fish stickers. Okay, so in our craft kit, we have some directions for you on how to do this craft. And as promised, comes with a fishbowl template on blue paper and a sheet of white paper, and a whole bunch of assorted fish foam stickers. And all you're going to want to do is take your template and then use your scissors. And if your kids are using them, make sure they're childproof safety scissors, and cut out your fishbowl template. And then you simply want to take your glue stick and you want to glue. Okay, make sure your glue stick isn't dried out. That's no good. Take a glue stick and you want to glue your fishbowl onto your paper. Make sure your paper is what we call landscape. It's going to be the long way, the horizontal way. And you just want to glue your fishbowl into the center of your paper, like so. And then you want to take your fish choices. And since we talked about red fish, we can take a red fish and our blue fish. And maybe we should do a yellow fish for our one fish. And maybe a starfish for our two fish. And you can put some other things in here if you want. We've got little seahorses, and we've got some flowers you could put on your paper. Maybe you want to put a crab up here. I don't know if a whale would belong in a fishbowl, but you could put one in there if you wish. You can design your fishbowl any way you wish. Every fishbowl will be different. We have another one that one of our patrons made for us. This was their example that they made. Very creative and very cute. So go ahead and design and decorate your fishbowl any way you want. The stickers that we've provided have peeling back stickers, so you can just peel the paper off and stick them on. If they're not sticking for some reason, just use glue and they will attach fine. And that's how you're going to do your one fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish craft. Now we have another craft in mind to go along with our Fox and Socks book. Now, I thought about having you guys learn how to make socks. But socks can be kind of smelly and stinky, and yeah, we're just going to go put these in the wash. So I thought, what can we do to make a craft of Fox and Socks? And I thought, what if we made a cozy fox? Isn't he cute? And this is really simple to do too. Again, if you come to the library in your craft kit, you're going to get everything that you need to make your fox, your cozy fox. And in that kit, we provide you with your directions on how to make the kit. We give you the template for the fox pieces. There's going to be two pages there. There is detailed directions on which pieces are which. And then we're also going to give you a sheet of blue paper. And we're also going to give you guys some newsprint, because that is what makes up our cozy fox. If you look closely here, you'll see that this is just painted newspaper and unpainted newspaper. So the first thing you're going to want to do when you make this craft is to get a newspaper and you want to paint it orange. Any orange color will do. Watercolors are best because they will still enable you to bleed through and see the print. And otherwise, if you use oil base, it takes longer to dry also. The watercolor should take maybe 15 to 20 minutes to dry, depending on how thick you put the paint on. I also recommend that when you're doing this, that you look for newsprint that is mostly writing. If you have too many pictures on it, like a front page here or an advertisement, that's not really going to be great for this because the pictures will bleed through the orange paint and it will make it harder to see. So you really want to look for newsprint that has a lot of print. And you're going to want to paint your newspaper. So I have some here, an example. And all you want to do is just mix your paint up and just put a little bit on here. And with a foam paintbrush, we found was best. You can also use your fingers, kids, if you like to finger paint. You can also use a Q-tip or a sponge. Paintbrushes do work, but they do tend to leave streak marks, and we don't really want that. So cotton balls, foam brushes, fingers, whatever you like. And just paint over the whole section of newsprint. Now, again, the one that I'm doing right here isn't the best example because it's not a lot of detailed print, but it would work for what you're going to be doing. And you want to make sure you get the entire sheet completely covered in paint and then let it dry. And like I said, that'll take about 15, 20 minutes depending on how much paint you put on. And when you're all done, your newsprint will look like this. It's going to be kind of crisp and curled up a little bit, and that's how you want it to look. That'll be perfect. So while your paint is drying, that gives you an opportunity to come along and cut out all of these pieces. And you may say, wow, Mrs. Post, that is a lot of pieces to cut out. But it really isn't that much, and the pieces are big enough for even the smallest fingers to use or safety scissors to cut them out. It's not really intricate detail. Where it says like fox body orange, you're going to want to take your cutout piece of your body here. Here's my example here. And you want to put that on the orange painted newsprint, just like this. And then you're going to want to trace it with a pen or a pencil, or if you're feeling really ambitious, just directly cut it out right out of the orange so that when you're all done, you get a piece that looks like this. And then you can throw your template away unless you plan to make more foxes for more papers. I think it's foxes. So anyways, you want to do that with all your pieces. So you're going to have an orange tail, just like this. And here where it says fox tail tip non-painted, that means that you want to pull out your newsprint that you haven't used, and you want to just have it just plain newsprint. You want to have a section of newspaper that was not painted. So make sure that with the newsprinter that we give you, that you're only painting part of it and leaving a small amount for it to be not painted. You're going to be doing that for the tip of the tail. You're going to do it for your fox's cheeks and for his inner ears. Everything else is going to be painted orange. And you can see that on our completed fox here. See, his inner ears are not painted, his cheeks are not painted, and the tip of his tail is not painted. Everything else was painted orange. So once you have all that cut out and everything is dried and you've traced everything on your papers and cut them out, you're going to be left with all these wonderful pieces. So here's your tail tip and your inner ears, like so. And we have our cheeks, and we have our big ears, our big triangle ears, and we have our tail and our face and our body. So we're going to start assembling our fox. And the first thing we're going to put on is going to be our fox's body. So you're going to want to take your glue. You're going to want to just glue the back side of the body like this. And you want to glue it to the bottom. Again, you want to make sure your paper is landscape. You want to glue it to about the middle of your blue sheet of paper on the bottom. I'm working upside down, so for me it looks like it's on the top, but it's on the bottom of your paper. And then you want to take your tail, and you want to do the same thing here with your tail. A couple things of glue on your tail. I also recommend using a glue stick for this part instead of the craft glue or the school glue, because that'll bubble up your paper and you want this to lay nice and flat. So you glued your tail. You'll notice that I lifted up the body and I glued it underneath just so it would fit on the paper. Otherwise, it's going to stick off the paper some. Then you want to take your tail tip, and on the back side here too, we want to apply just a little bit of glue and glue it to the top tip of your tail, just like that. And if you need a little bit more to make it stick, you can add a little bit more. Now it's time to do our fox's head. So again, here is our template with our headpiece underneath it. And once again, we just do a couple strips of glue underneath. And here you can be as creative with how you want your fox to look as you want. You can have his nose pointing towards his body. You can have it pointing away like he's looking far off. You can have it straight down. However you want to position the nose of your fox is fine. And we're going to put ours on an angle like so. And then we're going to put on his ears. So again, flipping them over. And again, just like I did with the tail, I'm going to tuck them under a little bit of his head here, like so. And the other one as well. Because I might have them pop over the top, we only put glue on the bottom. And we'll put this up here also. He's starting to look like a fox now, isn't he? And then you can take your inner ears that were not painted, and you can put a little bit of glue in the middle of those and put them on like so, also right in the middle of your big ear, just like this. Look at that a little bit closer so you can see. And again, here we're going to put a little bit on the back side of this. So now we have to add our fox's cheeks. And the cheeks are going to run right along the sides of the face here. So we can put our glue here and run that like so. I kind of line them up so that they line up. And a little bit on this side too. And we're going to run him like so also. It's okay if they overlap at the bottom because we're going to glue a pom-pom onto the bottom here where his nose goes. And in each kit, we provide you with a black pom-pom and two googly eyes. If you're not able to pick up the kit, you will need to get these from your local big box store or craft store. And you want to put some glue here on the bottom of his nose. And since we're not sticking very good here, we'll put a little bit more there. And you can use your school glue or your craft glue here as well. I actually do recommend that more than your glue stick for this part of it, just so that they stick a little bit better. But if you don't have that the school glue or the craft glue, your glue stick will work. And the same with their eyes. You want to put a little bit of glue on the back of the eyes and put them right here on his face like so. Now, if you really want to be creative and put socks on this fox, you certainly can. I would recommend that you get some yarn or some felt, and then you could cut some sock shapes and you could glue them underneath here if you really want to have socks on your fox. But if you want to just have him like he is here, then your project would be done at this point. So I hope you enjoy the crafts that we've put together for our Dr. Seuss birthday bash, and we look forward to seeing you guys again next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.